All right, good day, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to the Garena Premier League 2016. We are your shoutcasters. I am, of course, Amplifier, and I'm here with Arctic. We just had game one, and what are your thoughts? Let's just have a bit of a refresher on that first game.
Oh, God. You know, I was really hoping that Kanaya Gaming would at least pull something off on their last day in the Garena Premier League, but unfortunately, these things happen, you know, and hopefully this will be a lesson for them going into 2017 next year. You know, still a lot of chance, and I still see lots of potential in Kanaya Gaming. Probably just needs a little bit more time to develop over time.
Yeah, that's true. A lot of lessons to learn in this tournament. Of course, we're going to have second game. This is a do or die death match between Vestigial and BKT. For AEX. Actually, it's more of a do or die for AEX, because if they don't win this game, they will not make it to the semifinals this Saturday for the GPL. So this is a very, very important match right now. We're going to go straight into the pick and ban phase. So to take a look at the bans from AEX, Gnar, Jhin, and Zed banned out for the side of AEX. Meanwhile, Vestigial banning out Twitch, Shen, and Karma.
Yes, indeed. No surprise there. Lifor was one of the... He was an absolute beast on the Gnar these past few days. So no surprise, Acclaimed Empire X banning out the Gnar. And Jhin as well. I've been consistently talking about how Jhin is one of the strongest AD carries going into the Garena Premier League. You know, he's been dishing out tons of damage, and I feel like Vestigial is one of those teams that has been particularly efficient using the Jhin and the Zed as well. Ban onto Arakelic right there.
Yeah, so let's take a look at the picks. Rek'Sai being locked in first by AEX, no surprise, and then Vestigial going to be responding with Sivir and Graves as going to be the next jungler. No Hecarim going to be seen in this game as we've usually seen. And we're waiting for possible Tristana.
Yes,
because if the Twitch is not there, Tristana's there.
Exactly. And you know, Gen V, we all know, personally, we've seen how efficient he is on that Twitch in our own Garena Pro Gaming series. So I guess Vestigial really making sure that they ban out the Forte picks.
Just a sec. Vayne was locked in by Gen V. So this is going to be something we have not seen in a while for those who are catching up to AEX. This is really something we haven't seen in a while. It's something that Gen V used a lot during the group stage of the BGS. In fact, I think it was his most used champion during the group stage, but eventually he had to adjust to other champions. We're going to see it again this game, and I wonder if it'll go well.
Exactly. You know, I feel like this is the do or die moment, so Acclaimed Empire X should be technically not only bringing out some stronger picks, and I also feel like this is also the moment where they need to take a few risks, because during the past games, they have been pulling off some of their more signature cheese picks, like, for example, the Morgana top, and unfortunately, it didn't work. I feel like the team's already scouted them for the cheese pick, so again, this is the perfect moment to really bring on these picks in such a crucial game for today.
Yeah, we're seeing Vestigial, they respond with the Alistar and Trundle, so that will most probably be a Trundle top. Now we just wait for the mid lane and top lane of AEX, hovering over the Ahri again. Not sure if Karl will go for this one, because he didn't have such a good time the last time he went for this Ahri.
Exactly, that could have been a little bit traumatizing, but oh, the LeBlanc though, that's another story.
Yeah. So. Signature pick coming in from Calculated. He is more successful on the champion, most memorably during Rampage 2016, which is how they qualified for GPL in the first place. Now we just wait for a top laner. Gnar is not here, and Shen is not here, so I wonder who Cannon will grab. Will it be another Morgana? I'm actually kind of hoping not.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Hopefully not.
Yeah.
I was kind of worried about when you brought that up there.
Yeah. Echo is still open, actually. Rumble, for example, is also open, though Cannon does not play that champion. There's a hover over Echo.
There we go. I feel like the Echo is a fairly decent pick, you know, especially since if you're going to look at the past games for the Garena Premier League.
Yeah.
Echo, aside from the Gnar, I feel like Echo is one of the highlighted champions for this particular series right here. So going to the side of Vestigial, though.
Yeah, let's see which mid laner they're going to be locking in. Important thing to note, yung mid laner in the Vestigial, he is very new. Especially to this team, but there's going to be Lissandra locked in for the side of Vestigial to finish the team composition. So again, guys, we want to remind you that this is a do-or-die match for AEX. If they do not win this game, they will not make it to the semifinals on Saturday, because BKT is already... I mean, BKT, KLH, and Saigon Jokers, they're all three wins. So this is the only chance for AEX to tie up with three wins as well. So this is a very important game, and how are the team compositions looking for us here?
Well, actually, there was absolutely no hesitation for Vestigial, by the way, locking in that Lissandra there. You know, I feel like it's a very good pick, actually, going up against Calculated's LeBlanc right there. But overall, for Acclaimed Empire X, you know, I gotta be honest, I'm very particularly looking forward to Gen V on this vein because he does have a reputation for being a beast on this vein. So hopefully, you know, going into the Garena Premier League, he wouldn't disappoint, because we have seen a, I wouldn't say disappointments, but they kind of fell short of expectation. Like, for example, we usually know them for being strong with cheese picks and then calculated with the RA as well. So we'll see how this unfolds going into our second game for today.
Yeah, again, so guys, this is the Garena Premier League 2016. We are on Game 2. This is the last chance for our representatives from the Philippines, Acclaim Empire X, our pride and the pride of Iloilo. This is their very last chance to make it to the semifinals. They've had an amazing Cinderella run all the way from the BGS. They pretty much upset every single team they went against to make it here. And honestly, even if they don't make it past this game, they're still pretty much winners. They've gone through so much already, and you can say pretty much everything they go or everything they've done in the GPL is pretty much a lesson for them coming forward. But we still hope that both of these teams will give us a very good game. We're in the Summoner's Rift. Again, this is GPL and we are your Shoutcasters. I am Amplifier and I'm here with Arctic. And we're going in again to the second game of the day. The last chance of AEX to make it into the semifinals of the GPL.
Yes, indeed. And after this magic carpet ride, a rundown of the champs on Summoner's Rift for today. In the top lane, we have Cannon on the Echo. In the jungle, we have Tamsu on the Rek'Sai. In the mid lane, we have Carculated on the LeBlanc. And to sum up the bot lane, Gen V on the Beastly Vayne and Endless Ace on the Braum for support.
Yes, meanwhile, that's VTL on the red side. It's going to be TY for life. In the top lane with the Trundle, BBTY in the jungle with Graves, Ari Kellic in the mid lane with the Sandra, and for the dual lane, that's going to be Mexilu and Craw with Sivir and the Alistar. So we're seeing a deep invade again from AEX here on the blue side of VTL, something we've actually seen quite often from them. They always want to make sure that they know where the other jungler is going to start so Tamsu can plan out his jungle pathing. I'm actually quite glad that Zac was not picked by Tamsu in this game. To be honest, ever since Rampage, the Zac of Tamsu hasn't been looking so good. He hasn't really shown as much early game presence as before.
Yeah, and I feel like, as I've been saying, Garena Premier League, I've been particularly worried about Acclaim Empire X in the sense that they will be scouted out by these teams because AEX, if you kind of look at their champ pool, they have signature champs, but I feel like it isn't as wide as if you're going to compare it to the other teams in the Garena Premier League. But hopefully, you know, we'll see AEX pull this off going up against Singapore's Vestigial here. So in back into the game we go.
Yeah, so a little bit of vision being put down by VTL on the river, but overall it's going to be standard lanes, so no lane swaps going to be happening for this game. There's going to be Krug start for BBTY as well as for Tamsu. So taking a look at the composition so far, hopefully Tamsu will be able to help Carculated look good in this game. He has looked pretty inconsistent so far in the GPL, especially when using the Ahri, but this Leb, at least, he's looked better on this Leb compared to his other champions.
True indeed, and you know, hopefully Carculated will be able to pull this off, because if you're going to look at, I feel like there's a pattern as to how well the other teams have scouted Acclaim Empire X. They know that Tamsu is a dominant force in the early game, which is why they've effectively either counter-jungled or established some solid vision in the parts of Summoner's Rift here. And then another part is they know Carculated is a huge carry if left unchecked and if you just allow him to snowball. So that's another thing that I've noticed enemy teams look out for. So it's very interesting. I feel like there's a pattern that you can kind of see from AEX going to these games. So hopefully AEX kind of changes up the tempo a bit going in up against the schedule.
That's true. So seeing a bit of an exchange here in the bot lane, and Echo has actually a pretty nice lead. Gen V putting down some damage onto Craw, forcing him to back out with Mexilu already low on mana, probably throwing those boomerang blades too much. Again, Echo with a slight lead, but Trundle was able to catch up and Echo puts down an early ward in the river. Graves is still in blue, and Tamsu actually was looking for a gank, but he's going to be backing out.
Oh, but here we go. The jungler, BBTY, in the bottom river. So
yeah,
we might need to look out for that.
Actually, we're seeing so much harass here in the bot lane. Mexilu's having a bit of a hard time sustaining, especially since the Alistar nerf from before. He isn't as good during the early game. His heal was also nerfed, so there isn't as much sustain. So we'll see what's going to happen. Rek'Sai is already in the blue buff, so we'll see where he'll go from here. Because in the previous games that we've been watching from Tamso, I remember I was mentioning that he hasn't been as impactful as we've known him for in the jungler. He hasn't been able to really snowball the lanes as much. So hopefully he'll be able to show up more in this game, especially since he's on a more comfortable... I think he's on a more comfortable champion, to be honest.
True.
Compared to his performance on Zac, his Rek'Sai has looked much better.
Yes, indeed. And I feel like if you're going to look at Tamsu's strengths, he is extremely efficient at dominating early. And I feel like Rek'Sai is the perfect champion for him, as opposed to the performance that we've seen him on Zac and the Graves. So interesting how this will play out for Acclaim Empire X. You know, hopefully Tamsu does utilize that fact running the Rek'Sai here. But
Yep, we're seeing a possible gank here, although might not be so successful considering the flash is up. Maybe they'll be able to burn this one, but he's getting really close, and there's going to be the gank. He actually moves way too far forward. The knockup's not going to land. There it is, and there's going to be the flash actually moving toward BBTY. He's already here to respond for the gank. The red buff is there as well. Tamsu's forced to flash out, and BBTY tries to get the kill. There's the flash as well from Cannon, and that's a pretty awkward gank. Good job from BBTY to respond.
Yes, indeed, and very interesting there. Tamsu, an inch from death, had he not exhausted the flash there. But then again, still no kills for either side. Both teams will live yet another day in the top lane, so there we go.
Actually, a bit of a misplay from Tamsu there. He tunneled way too far forward. He actually could have just walked forward, but we're going to see a bit of a mid lane exchange here. Both mid laners running a bit low. That's going to be the Negatron actually for Ari Kalik, meaning she was forced to back. Missing a bit of CS there.
So yes, there we go. The bot lane being pushed a little bit by this Tiju right there.
Yeah, so we'll see Cannon actually getting a bit low on HP there. But we're going to see no significant gold lead so far. And the CS is actually pretty even for most of the lanes. We're not seeing a huge lead though. Genvi actually getting a bit low there. And yeah, we're going to be back. I think we're just experiencing the technical difficulties. But actually, we're seeing so far things are looking very even. I was a bit afraid for AEX bot lane because Alistar Sivir, that's a bit painful.
True.
As a bot lane against the Vayne and the Braum. However, despite the nerfs on Braum's Q harass, honestly, the Vayne-Braum combo is still very safe. Even without sustain, you're able to put that shield to keep Vayne safe, and then you can proc the stun to be able to help you. And we're seeing Genvi, you know, like you said, he does very well on the Vayne. It's something he's very comfortable with. So despite the matchup, he's still doing pretty well.
Indeed, indeed. And there we go. Back into the game we go for game two of the last day of the group stage for the Garena Premier League between AEX and Vestigial.
Yeah, so let's see. Again, so far, laning phase looking pretty even. And again, FYI, guys, we're still on patch 6.15. I'm sure that some of you have read 6.16. Actually, already came out today with some pretty interesting changes, but we won't be seeing them for this game. Although, to be honest, I'm really excited about the new arcade skins coming out. That was Ari. Oh, wait, you might see a dive here. BBTY trying to dive down the tower. He puts down the smoke, but there's not going to be a dive. Just a bit too risky since none of them are on level 6, but BBTY is actually staying here for quite a long time. And this ace moving in, actually, to try and land down some poke. I don't think that was worth it. He's very low. And this dual lane is going to be forced to run away. No TPs either from any of the top lanes. So it looks like VTL are just looking to put down a bit of damage on this turret. Cloudrake is actually up in Carl, moving down to the bot lane, but he is going to go back.
Yes, indeed. And Vestigial will be backing out from that. Kind of risky, especially how far pushed they are in that bot lane right there. So still fairly even playing field, I'd say. So it's all a matter of who will be pulling the trigger first and benefit from that pull.
That's definitely true. A bit of CS lead in the top lane for Cannon on this Echo. He does have the Sheen already. Meanwhile, the Tiamat for TY for life. And in the bot lane, there's a slight CS lead for Sivir. But again, nothing too serious, nothing too significant. That's the Catalyst being purchased by Calculated. Quite interesting, actually. Calculated always opting to pick Rod of Ages on pretty much any mid laner he plays. What is your opinion on that? Because when we look at other regions, Rod of Ages, yes, it is an option, but most of the time we're seeing something like Abyssal or Morella Nomicon, Ludens, things like that.
I think it's very interesting that you brought that up, especially when you're on a LeBlanc. You kind of expect to... Especially for LeBlanc, you'd kind of utilize that she is one of those heavy damage dealers. Yeah. And going up a little, I guess then again, going up against the Lissandra, I kind of get it. Knowing that the Lissandra has a bit more survivability in that mid lane, coupled by the fact that Arakelic is going for that Negatron cloak right there. So Calculated won't be able to take down the Lissandra that easily.
Yeah, that's true. And actually, I also noticed, although I don't know if Gen V will do it this game, we're actually seeing he does have the Bilgewater Cutlass, so he's going to go for the Blade of the Ruined King first. But I also noticed in the itemization of Gen V, he also has a favorite item, which is the Static Shiv. He gets it on nearly 80 carry that he brings into the game. He got it on Twitch. I think he brought it on a couple of other ADCs as well. And it was interesting to me because usually we see Twitches run something like Runons and then Yomus.
Yes.
But what do you, for example, on Twitch, what do you think about getting static on him after Runons instead of the Yomus?
Well, I guess it all depends on how far you are at in the game, you know.
Yeah.
But then again, very interesting. But ooh, hold that thought.
A bit
right
of an exchange
there.
Stun, one more hit. There's going to be the proc, but they won't be pushing forward with that engage. Sightstone already for both supports. And there's going to be the ult from Mexilu. BBTY is here, and LSA's in a very bad position. He actually chose to run toward the river to try and distract them away from Gen V. That's going to be giving first blood to BBTY for BTL.
Yes,
and there's going to be another gank here. Actually, Damsu is going to try and respond. The stun barely landing. There's actually going to be the knock-up just in time for the stun to land. TY4 life is getting very low. He doesn't have the flash. And that's going to be a kill for Cannon in the top lane.
Very well played by both sides there. At least, you know, it was a one-for-one trade. Although first blood going to Vestigial right there. And I got to commend Endless Ace there. You know, he wanted to minimize the casualties happening in the bot lane. And by running the other direction, at least Gen V was able to run to safety right there.
That's definitely true, Calculated. Getting rooted down there by Lissandra, but he's not going to be receiving too much damage. Meanwhile, bot lane was already taken by BTL, so they're going to get the first blood gold bonus. And Arakelic forcing the passive. I thought she was going to ult, since she does have the ignite and flash instead of the TP. That's going to be the top lane turret being taken by AEX, but because of the bot lane control that BTL have, they might be able to get this dragon. However, they're probably looking for an engage. Arakelic gets down the route. She does have the E. Will they dive this turret?
Oh my goodness, Endless Ace almost in a virtually bad position right there, being caught out by virtually now four members of Vestigial pushing this mid lane.
Yeah, they're going to be pushing in this mid lane, and the wave clear is very, very nice actually from the side of BTL. They have the Sivir Graves and the Sandra for the wave clear. Calculated just trying to put down some poke, but Cannon's actually here. He gets a two-man stun, and there's going to be the follow-up. Lissandra puts down the ult. Will it be enough to disengage? There's Calculated on the side, trying to put down some damage, but BBTY takes out Endless Ace. That's his second death at 10 minutes in the game.
Oh my goodness, AEX looking a little bit squishy. If you're going to look at the comparison here between in the 4v4, I feel like Vestigial had a bit more macho.
Yeah.
I was looking a little bit more macho there, and look, as a result, if you're going to notice how that went, Acclaim Empire X's health bars were a little bit more faster in depletion in comparison to Vestigial. And in the end, Vestigial was able to benefit from that and get a kill off of Acclaim Empire X in the end.
Yeah, overall, it was a pretty weird engage coming from AEX. Another thing that I noticed, actually, with the previous games of AEX is that they don't read. It feels like they don't really capitalize on their composition when it hits its power spike. Because let's say, for example, we look at the team fight from earlier.
Yes.
Echo and Vayne don't really hit their power spike up until around two core items. So for them to be engaging this early on, when you're against a Graves, Lissandra, and Sivir, who all spike really early, compared to Vayne at least, and to Echo, you have to wonder why AEX would take such a fight when they know they'd be at a disadvantage because of the champions they're using.
Exactly. I've been wondering exactly that. And it kind of showed in their previous games wherein they were kind of going aggressive at moments wherein the enemy team kind of had the advantage due to the spikes.
Yeah.
So, again, Acclaim Empire X has to really be careful that they at least wait out for Gen V here and even calculated to get the items that they need to have relevance going into the small skirmishes and even the clashes.
Mm, that's very true. We're seeing a lot of focus on this top lane. It's the next objective since mid and bot turret were already taken by VTL. This is the only remaining outer turret for VTL to take. AEX is moving towards that side. The Sandra's actually roaming toward the bot lane because Dragon's actually still up. No one has taken this Cloud Drake since it did spawn. Cannon's going to be defending this lane. He doesn't have TP, but TY for life does. So AEX have to be a bit careful in this top lane. BBTY is there as well.
Oh yes, so there we go. BBTY catching this ward off here. Very good attempt at deep wards coming from Acclaim Empire X here. But oh, a little bit of a trade-off coming from Cannon and Life Orb here in the bot lane.
Yeah, Tamsu actually moving to mid lane, but Arikelic is moving away. There's so much vision by AEX on the Rift Herald area, so Arikelic will be spotted out. Cannon pushing up bot lane. He might roam to top now. Not sure what's going to happen here. It looks like VTL is just waiting for the right opportunity to dive this top lane turret. There goes a bit of a skirmish by Cannon, but I don't think anything's going to happen there. Now there's going to be VTL pushing in this turret, making good use of their power strike at this point. There's already a BF sword for Mexilu, and I believe Arikelic is quite close already to the Abyssal Scepter. Carl and Tamsu, though, trying to get the mid lane turret.
Very interesting how Vestigial is playing out. They're playing the numbers game, and at the same time, knowing that Acclaim Empire X can't really do that much, knowing that when you have those four champions grouped together and when you try to engage on them, that's going to be a huge risk. And Vestigial just capitalizing on that beautifully here.
Yeah, four turrets already taken at 13 minutes in, and AEX not responding whatsoever to these objectives. They're able to just give it away, and there's going to be ult coming in from Sivir. Tamsu actually gets locked down. There's way too much CC onto Tamsu. He flashes through the wall, and that's going to be Cannon as the next target, though they can't lock him down. Calculated try to do what he can, but we won't be seeing any engage just yet. They're probably going to go for this inner turret. I don't think AEX will be able to defend this one.
Oh my goodness, very interestingly played by Vestigial. They're really capitalizing on the...
Actually, there's going to be a several man stun, and Arikelic gets very low. There's going to be ult from Endless AC, flashes away. The burn won't be able to kill him, and Genvi tries to move in with his ult as well. He won't be able to take anyone down, but at the very least, they're able to save their mid-inner turret. Now comes in Tamsu. He's trying to follow up with the CC. I don't think they'll be able to chase anyone down, though. That's going to be Cannon very low on mana, so they won't be able to get this one. Maybe, though, they can get the Cloud Drake.
I gotta say, though, Acclaim Empire X is doing a fairly decent job, I'd say, at trying to prolong this game just enough so that they could reach their power spikes going into the mid and late game.
Yep.
So I'd say that, sure, Vestigial is taking advantage of the earlier advantages they have by pushing as hard as they can, but as the timer, as the game goes on later during the game, Acclaim Empire X is just going to have a field day once particularly Genvi reaches the spikes that he needs. And I feel like, you know, Genvi, knowing how efficient he is on this Vayne, Acclaim Empire X is just going to go above and beyond and explode as this game goes on. So long as they're able to hold the, I'd say the aggressiveness in terms of sieging coming from Vestigial here.
Yeah, I'm a bit afraid for AEX right now considering they are behind in turrets, but like you said, they just want to delay the game. Exilu gets picked by Calculated, doing what he does best.
Yes.
Getting people while they're not looking, it's pretty mean. Akra here, gonna get stunned actually. There goes the Pulverize, but I don't know if he'll be able to escape this one. Arikelic though, coming in with a response. There's a TP from TY4Life just in case. I don't know if they'll be able to take them down, though. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's going to be a disengage. Meanwhile, Cannon trying to bully out TY4Life still in this lane. Wherever TY4Life goes, Cannon seems to follow.
Yes, so monkey see, monkey do.
Yeah.
They're right there. So, I believe Acclaim Empire X will be taking down this bottom tower as a result. Now, as far as objectives, I'd say Acclaim Empire X, again, I gotta hand it to them. They're doing a fairly good job at making sure they're keeping up with the pace that Vestigial is pressing onto them.
They're actually playing very safely compared to the previous games that we've seen. They're just really taking the game, very slowly. They were able to get that Cloud Drake, so they will get the additional movement speed from that. I believe that's 25 movement speed out of combat. Rift Herald is still up, though. And we're going to see what AEX decides to do. The game is still pretty even. They were able to catch up in terms of turrets. That's 4-3. And 60 minutes into the game, still things looking very even. And anyone could win this game. AEX, though, I guess because this is the do-or-die match, they're playing very safely, making sure not to make any mistakes in this game.
Yes, I feel like it kind of goes both ways, pros and cons. You know, at one point, you know, we... usually see AEX in a more aggressive stance. And as you've said, this is a pace that we do not normally see from them. But then again, this is a pro at the same time, because that is what they should be doing, knowing that Vestigial has been taking advantage of their early aggression. And AEX, I feel, is handling this very well. And I feel like that's the development that we're seeing from a team coming from Iloilo right there.
Yeah, that's very true. We usually, like you said, we usually see AEX, you know, especially with Tamsu being a part of the team, very aggressive during that early game to try and get the lane snowballing. But in this game, it's looking like they're content. Arikalik almost getting caught out there. He's actually been clawing away, and there goes Calculated. He puts down the chains, but he gets stunned. Actually, there's the ult coming from Arikalik. It's going to be a full-on team fight, and the TY for life is here with the TP. Cannon gets focused. He has to ult out, and that's going to be Tamsu being the next target. Calculated very, very low, and Tamsu has to try and run away. There's the flash from Arikalik. He can't finalize the kill. That's going to be a disengage, and no one dies from that fight.
Oh my goodness, what could have been potentially a bloodbath, but still everybody survives yet another day on Summoner's Rift. I gotta say, interestingly played by both Acclaim Pyrex and Vestigial right there.
That's very true. No one dies in that fight. Gold is still even. No objectives, but one last hit on this turret, and that's gonna be another turret for VTL. Dragon is gonna spawn. Actually, there isn't even a timer yet, so there's all the time in the world for these teams to manage their waves. Top lane is pushing in favor of AEX, so we'll see how they decide to respond to that. For now, that'll be Mexilu content to just take a red buff.
Exactly, and that Drake is looking very juicy right now, especially Infernal Drake. I feel like both teams will be able to...
Oh, is that Infernal?
Yes, that is the Infernal Drake as the next trait right there. And looking at the compositions here, I feel like both teams would really skyrocket and benefit from the damage amplification that they'd get from that Infernal. So interesting, let's see what'll happen. Which team will be able to get that Drake?
Yeah, we have to take note though, VTL is on a timer right now, because the longer this game lasts, the more that Sivir and Graves' damage will start to fall off. And Echo, well, no, not really Echo, but Vayne, rather, will start to scale toward that late game.
Exactly.
So the longer that this game is even, the better for AEX, because Gen V will just continue to scale up until that late game. Rift Herald was taken by AEX, and VTL looking to respond by taking in this mid lane. The stun, looking to be taken down, and there's the ult actually being burst onto Arikalik. He goes down immediately. Calculated completely bursted from that fight, and that's going to be the mid inner turret for VTL. No response whatsoever from AEX because they decided to take the Rift Herald. That's going to be a trade pretty much in objectives for both teams.
Very interestingly played by Vestigial, because as you've said, AEX is a ticking time bomb right now, and Vestigial should be taking advantage of what early and mid game objectives that they can take, because if left unchecked, AEX is just going to give them an extremely hard time going into that late game. But still 20 minutes into the game right now, so Vestigial still having a chance at utilizing what they can before going into those later phases of the game.
Yeah, so 20 minutes in, like you said, around a 2,000 gold lead so far for BTL, and looking like they're taking the objectives pretty cleanly. Not that many deaths, actually 3-3 on the kill score so far, so both teams playing very safely, and VTL taking a good advantage of their lead so far. Infernal Drake up in 20 seconds though, and VTL just setting down some vision, which is what they should be doing. Very little vision here coming in from AEX, so we'll see what happens. Scuttle is secured by VTL.
Okay, so there we go. Regardless, whoever wins this, we will be seeing going into a tiebreaker later to determine the seeding. That'll be past 7 p.m., so that'll be Kuala Lumpur Hunters. No, not Kuala Lumpur Hunters, but...
Is it the one with 3 points? So that's going to be KLH.
The winner earlier.
BKT.
Yes, BKT going up against whoever wins this game, because both members will be 3-2, so it's all a matter of how the seeding will go for the playoffs, so look out for that. But nonetheless, going back to this game, the more important game at hand.
Yes, Infernal Drake is already up, and Tamsu's actually here first. VTL, not here just yet, although they were the ones who set down Vision. There is no TP for TY for life, so he's going to take a very long time to walk over to this lane. Their Infernal Dragon's actually set, and BBTY starts the fight. There's a double pulverize onto AEX. The TP comes in from Cannon as well, and Arikalik tries to put down the CC. Shields herself to survive. BBTY, though, very low. Cannon trying to do what he can to the backline. Genvi gets the kill, and that's going to be AEX winning both the team fight And they get the Infernal Drake as well.
Exactly. Actually, it's very good that you pointed that out. You know, Life Orb, I feel like Vestigial was indeed in a scarier position, knowing that there were still a few seconds left before Life Orb teleport up, and they did pay for that dearly. AEX capitalizing on that absolutely beautifully by getting a kill off to Arikelic right here.
Very true. Cannon was able to push the top lane before he went to TP down to the Dragon. So TY for Life not able to manage his top lane wave, so he ends up walking and getting way too late to the Dragon fight. And that's going to be a nice boost for AEX. They have both Dragons so far in the game, Infernal and Cloud Drake. And the gold has reduced from around a 2,000 gold lead to 1,000 gold lead. Things looking very even. And like we said, VTL is on a timer. So the longer this game lasts, the better it'll be for AEX, because they do have the Vayne.
Yes, indeed. Vestigial slowly running out of time if they continue to leave this unchecked. Gen V now 2-0 on that Vayne. It just adds more insult to the injury. Like, as we've said, Gen V on that Vayne is going to look very good into the late game. And looking at who the as far as who the kills have been going to so far, again, to Gen V. So that's going to give Vestigial a little bit of a hard time if they don't do anything about this now that they're going into this mid-game phase here.
Yeah, 23 minutes into the game. What will VTL do? The map is looking very dark for VTL when they should be the one to have vision up. They were able to take a lot of the objectives during the early game, but now they seem a little bit lost as what to do at this mid-game. Maybe they should be putting down more vision to make more picks, because right now, in terms of items, VTL would still be stronger. But now they can underestimate AEX, because Cannon does have that Trinity Force, actually. Instead of going for your usual tank build with Echo, you know, Iceborne, Gauntlet, Sunfire, he goes for the Trinity Force, so that's a pretty painful Echo there.
Exactly, and oh my goodness, there we go. They're trying to clear out the vision established by Claim Empire X here.
Yeah, there's going to be Gen V getting the red buff, and they're starting to move over to Baron. VTL just tries to take out the wards. They are baiting over at this Baron fight. Although, to be honest, at this point in the game, I'm not as confident for VTL as I was earlier, because now AEX actually showing that they can match the damage, unlike, you know, around maybe the 15-minute phase of the game.
Exactly. And again, it just goes to show that AEX has been very, I'd say, very well very well calculated in terms of managing what, you know, the as far as managing Vestigial, knowing that they had that early game advantage. And again, Vestigial needs to start flexing some muscles here, because things are going to look very bleak for them as this game goes on.
Very true. That's going to be VTL moving over to this mid lane. The turret is not there anymore, though, so they're just looking to catch someone off guard, just waiting for the right moment to engage. Although AEX playing very safely, they do have vision around the area, so they're not going to fall for anything. Next Drake is going to be Infernal again. So we'll see if VTL will decide to take this Baron, or if they're just going to bait for a team fight. Meanwhile, like I was saying earlier, still looking forward to the arcade skins.
Yes.
Especially the Ari. I heard she just got Chromas, is that true?
Oh yeah, the different colors
and
there.
That's green. I think there's a pink one.
Yes.
Blue? I think there are two more. I think it was four. Four of them, but I can't remember how many there were.
I feel like, as far as where we are at in terms of the peripheral industry, it's very apt, because we know we have seen these peripherals being released with the color changing. So very interesting how Riot incorporated that into RE right there.
Very true. We're seeing AEX moving towards the Baron pit now, and Trundle still trying to manage his waves, getting pushed in actually down the bot lane, and Cannon has done a very good job of pushing in the waves before moving over to objectives to make sure Trundle is far away before he can get to the objective. AEX trying to take over a couple of camps in the jungle. And we'll see if they'll be able... I can smell a Baron fight anytime.
Yes, indeed. And I'm honestly a little bit worried for Vestigial here, because if you're going to look at the way they distributed the kills here, it's mostly, as far as a good record, it's on the Graves. And we all know that, sure, as we've said, BBTY is going to have a really great time on the Graves in the earlier phases of the game, but come late game, what is that 2-0-1 going to do, knowing that there's going to be a few scary beasts here on the side of AEX?
Yeah, that's true. Actually, I think VTL put down the towers too early.
Yes, that's true.
I'm actually thinking maybe what they should have done instead is to keep the turrets up and then just dive Gen V over and over again, rack up the kills, put them on Saver, put them on Grave, so that they have enough damage to, you know, really snowball to end the game. But what they did was, sure, they got a lot of turrets during the early game, but they barely have any kills, and they didn't take advantage of the turrets that they had earlier. So
That's actually very well rationalized. Indeed.
And again, that is just going to bite Vestigial in the butt here. And so look at this. AEX just kind of... We haven't seen them as confident in the earlier game, knowing that they... Oh, hold that thought,
though. There might be an engage here. Kind of actually putting down a lot of damage onto TY for life. His teammates don't seem to care right now. They're just sitting at the mid lane. But AEX, the rest of them care. They're here. They're going to try and get the kill. Cannon gets quite low, but I think they might be able to get this one. TY for life, though. He's TPing to the Baron. It was a bait all along. Will they be able to finish this Baron before AEX get there in time? Braum is here. The Baron's taking quite long, though, to fall down in HP. The rest of AEX are here. There's the TP coming from Cannon. He's been able to regenerate. And right now, VTL are just locked in. Who's going to get this Baron? It's actually going to be VTL. There's going to be the team fight, and AEX actually gets very low. Where are the kills? No one's dying so far, but that's going to be the first kill. Going over to TY for life, there's going to be Jambi with another kill, but the rest of VTL are low. Will they decide to re-engage? Cannon is quite low as well. There's going to be the stun. The flash is out. Man, all the carries of VTL are actually very low, but AEX having a very difficult time trying to engage. There's going to be the claw, but he's not going to follow up with the CC. And right now, VTL, they're trying to run away. AEX, though, I don't think they have the CC to lock this one down. Cannon, though, still very persistent, and wow, the re-engage from Ari Kelly. He's able to get the shutdown kill, and that's going to be a 4-for-2 plus the Baron for VTL.
Oh my goodness, that was kept on going back and forth, but then again, I got to commend Vestigial for really calculating in. Again, you just we're just kind of thinking that AEX was going to have that. But then again, here we go, looking at this replay here, you know, Vestigial really planning this out very well by baiting them into going far with the Trundle. But then again, AEX in kind of in the nick of time here. So here we go, have Cannon trying to stall as much as he can while AEX makes it to this Baron here. And here we go, AEX trying to make the most out of this. But then again, getting caught in this Baron pit. And Genvi's not exactly in the best position to deal as much, you know, just to follow up here.
Yeah.
And then VTL, it's pretty much anyone's game here. It's all a matter of outsmarting, and that's what they've been trying to do. And then again, if you're going to look at this, Cannon just really going efficiently while trying to set up for Genvi here. So there we go. Then again, we have that chase that we did see earlier, and then Genvi taking down BP. Rather, it was Cannon that took down BBT, right? So then
actually,
again,
there's another fight. We'll have to go live. It was the Infernal Drake being taken by VTL, and there's going to be an engage. Onto Calculate, he actually moves back to try and disengage. There's going to be the claw, and he's in a very awkward position. He's on the enemy side, and BBTY will try to finalize the kill. There's the ult, but it is not enough, and now AEX are trying to push in. We have to go back to that Baron fight, I think, but whoop. Yeah, look into it, get another engage. Samson's actually the one who's locked down. He's going to get very low, and the Glacial Fissure will not do anything. Carl, he moves in, but he actually goes down, and Cannon has to be forced to re-engage. Endless Ace, he's the only one left who wants to fight. Gen V slowed down. There's the pillar, there's the damage. Then that's going to be a 3-for-0, plus the Dragon for VTL. I don't know what's happening to AEX right now.
Oh my goodness, that was a fumble back-to-back-to-back-to-back coming from Acclaim Empire X, and Vestigial capitalizing on it beautifully. And this is a very scary situation for Acclaim Empire X, because in terms of potential to get as many objectives as they can into the base, Vestigial going to really capitalize on that. And that's going to put Acclaim Empire X in a very awkward position, because sure, they do have that late game, but the push is just too heavy coming from Vestigial here.
Yeah, they're going to get two inhibitors right now, VTL with an Infernal Drake of their own, and almost a 10,000 gold lead within almost 7 minutes. They're able to secure that big a gold lead just because of what happened early at Baron. So I want to go back to the Baron fight, because I think the team fight was the team fight and positioning was the worst thing for me in that fight. If we could just get a replay of that again, because if you look at the positioning, actually, Braum was not with Genvi.
Yes.
And Calculated also was not able to land that much damage. Cannon actually also had a misplay there. He actually put the stun on someone who wasn't the jungler.
Yes.
So BBTY was actually still able to smite. If Cannon was able to put down the stun on BBTY, maybe Tamsu could have stolen it, and then they could have disengaged or maybe even won the fight after. But I just think overall the positioning of the members of AEX wasn't that good, because Braum should have been with Genvi to move forward as like an unstoppable damage machine. But they were kind of split up during the Baron fight, and VTL just took completely took advantage of that.
Exactly, and those are mistakes that Acclaim Empire X shouldn't be making, knowing that supposedly in these later phases, the advantage is leaning towards them. But then again, that just goes to show that the smallest mistakes can really bite them in the back, and Vestigial just looking in a very good position here as far as the objectives that they have obtained so far. Seven towers being taken, and sure, one dragon, which is the Infernal, so that just further amplifies their damage. And in a way, I'd say it kind of evens out the playing field as far as the spikes that AEX has, since they do have that extra damage. But oh, here we go.
Yeah, this is going to be the bot inner turret now, and all of the alts of VTL are up, so they're very confident to take this one because they know AEX can't respond to that objective. Now they're just looking at the last inhibitor of AEX to try and finish off the game. Will AEX, you know, step up for this possible last team fight? They really have to if they want to keep the dream alive and, you know, go to the international wildcard as a continuation of their Cinderella run so far. We'll see if VTL will be able to use or make good use of their lead so far. 8,000 gold lead and calculated, just trying to put down some damage. Tamsu rotating around this area, but he's having a hard time because TY4Life is there. There's the wave clear. There's the damage going down onto the turret, and Ari Kellic not following up for the engage, but Tamsu, he's actually going to move in, and he gets very low. There's the ult, and man, that hurts. Endless Ace is going to go down immediately, and AEX are being forced to run away. There's a nice condemn on the BBTY, but I don't think it's going to be enough. That's going to be a one-for-one trade so far in canon. He ults away. This is still a third inhibitor for VTL, and they're looking to end the game at this point. Not many ults up, though. So this could be pretty risky for VTL.
Indeed. And Acclaim Empire X, you know, they are just in a very bad position. Sure, they have that late game advantage as far as the champions that they have, but they are just not in a position to really reach the optimum snowball that they need here. And Vestigial Gaming, I feel like in terms of calculation, you know, especially with everything that's on the line right now, Vestigial just really pulling the stops here, and I feel like Acclaim Empire X is going to have an extremely hard time regardless of the power spikes that Gen V has already reached.
That's very true. He has two items so far and was forced to get the Quicksilver early, so that definitely puts him behind. We're going to see what VTL decides to do next. The Elder Drake is spawning in a minute and 20 seconds, so that could be very useful to ending this game. Baron is also coming up at 30, but it looks like VTL are looking to set their eyes on this Baron. They're going to be putting around Vision. Endless Ace actually in the area as well to try and put down Vision of his own for the team.
Acclaim Empire X, I feel like they really should establish a bit of Vision on this Baron, because I feel like once Vestigial gets that Baron, it's pretty much over for Acclaim Empire X. You know, knowing that all the towers are down, for the inhibitor turrets are down, and it's all a matter of time wherein Vestigial, if they get those objectives, it's pretty much, I'd say, a virtual game over for Acclaim Empire X right now.
They're having so much trouble because of the lack of wave clear too.
Exactly.
On their composition, unlike VTL, who clearly have no problem whatsoever killing a bunch of minions in one go. Looking like they don't even need the Baron. Actually, VTL moving in. There's going to be a possible stun coming in at TY4Life. Actually gets stunned, but there's going to be no follow-up. This turret, though, Nexus turret, very low, and Ari Kellic scaring them with the E, and that's going to be calculated, trying to do some poke damage of his own. Mexilu, though, going to try and get it, and there's going to be the first Nexus tower down. This is going to be the last team fight. AEX, they're trying to do what they can, but that's already two kills coming in for VTL. The Nexus turrets are down. It's open. Gen V, he's very low, and I don't think he's going to survive. There's a nice condemn, but that's going to be AEX losing this game, and that's pretty much VTL shutting down their dream of making it to the semifinals this Saturday for the GPL.
Yes, unfortunate for Team Philippines right now, but nonetheless, I'd say we still have to give some commendations to Acclaim Empire X. You know, their first time making it, I'd consider this actually international, you know, going up against Southeast Asia's finest team. So you got to hand it to them. That was still very well played, and I feel like they still have tons of potential they can capitalize on. This is just only the beginning for them. You know, they have that experience now, and hopefully they'll learn from this, and we'd see greater things from them moving forward.
Very
but nonetheless,
true.
Congratulations to Vestigial as we look at the final standings
here.
Yeah,
so end game screen here. Mexilu with a nice KDA together with BBTY. That's 514 for BBTY and 417 for Mexilu. Ari Kellic with a lot of assists as well. He was able to do well in terms of KP in this game. Gen V, despite getting the 4-1, not able to translate it into a win. So that's going to be it for AEX in their journey. But like you said, so much to learn from this. bam, 30,000 damage. Actually, from Eric Kellick, he was able to do a lot of damage, especially in team fights, locking down core targets and then using that AoE, you know, to lock down Calculated. He was able to lock down Tamsu, two very important players, obviously, for AEX.
Exactly. And Eric Kellick, I got to commend him, you know, coming in as the rookie for Vestigial, you know, he really showed, especially when it matters. And again, you got to hand it to Team Singapore here. Very well played by Vestigial here. And of course, very well played as well to Acclaim Empire X. But nonetheless, ladies and gentlemen, that was game two for the third and final day of the Garena Premier League. Once again, we are your casters for today. This is Arctic.
And I am Amplifier. And again, guys, so much to learn from this game. Despite AEX being out of the semifinals, they still had a really great run from the tiebreaker in the PGS all the way to Rampage and then making it all the way here. We truly hope that they've learned a lot from this journey, as well as VTL. You know, I'm sure they're very happy with the wins that they've gotten. We're going to move into the third game, so we'll be back in a short break. Don't go away. Tilu BBTY is here, and LSA's in a very bad position. He actually chose to run to